that makes you learn more vibrantly. Students, there shouldn't be a gap. Okay, and entrepreneurship is all about excitement. You should like doing what you do. Like, just keep creating and throwing out, but not for the money. Not for the money. I'll never look at it. Never for the money. That's why I don't know. I don't care any money. When you ask me, I have no money. Okay? Now, the truth is, I don't carry money. I had to take lunch and he paid for the lunch. Okay, because I don't carry money, or it's in the car, I don't know where it is. The whole idea is, keep doing what you do, money will come. Because the time you start running for money, it doesn't come. You're calculating for the money. But finances have to be strong. Finances, perfect. All of you are science students, and I am a pure science student as well. Engineering and then masters in biology, biotechnology. So pure sciences. But my finance has been my key. Every time I've fallen multiple times. I've had 43 ideas, 43 ideas have failed. And 43 ideas have passed. So the failure here counted was money. Your finance is failed. But the point is, if you are financially well planned and written, your script, I call the script, I don't call it a business plan, I call it like script. The script should be written so perfectly that you should know next month, the sixth month, or the first year, what will happen, how someone will react. This comes by just sitting and analyzing, not experience alone. Your vision, entrepreneurship. Nobody taught me entrepreneurship. It was my keen vision that I become an entrepreneur. It's not that I never worked. I worked for 9 months. That's the last I could do because my mom wanted me to work. So, okay. And then they said they won't pay me for my ideas. Because my aim of starting a business was, I think, 6 years old. I've done a lot of things. When I was in school, I used to sell maps. You remember you get 1 rupee map?
Yes.
So, I come from a middle class family. We had a lot of financial problems when I was young. So my mom, I didn't have a father. He went away. When I was 8 years old, he went away. I feel good he went away one day. So it's all about positivity. I'm not saying it in a negative way. Please don't take it in a negative way. Okay? I'm not here to judge what my father is or nothing. Just that, he's that. Oh. Okay. So my mother has to push me and my brother to study, and I'm a very bad education person. Every year I go, I fail. So my mom will go convince the principal saying next year you'll do well. They pass me at the late standard. Okay. And then the principal says this is over. I can't pass him anymore. What if he fails in the next standard? And then no school in Bangalore gave me a seat. Because I failed even the entrance exam of English. The so-called English what I speak to you all now with a British accent or whatever. I failed. They said this fellow is so dumb that he doesn't even know English. Okay. And then my mom convinced saying, oh, just give him an opportunity. And I ended up doing really well with education because I understood that this is what it is, like what you write. I meant my knowledge, I knew how knowledgeable I was, but I couldn't put it on paper. So I understood, okay, this is the output you need if someone has to respect you or give you that. I call it like a gate pass. Then I started writing and then you become the school dropout. Okay, mathematics, my sir said, you don't come to tuition, you will flunk. Of course, I flunked the whole thing. But on the 10th, I got 96. Okay. He couldn't keep his face. Mm-hmm. Because he had a bet with me and my mother saying he will definitely fail. Because I failed continuously. The point is, I wasn't bothered about the internals or the mark. I straight went to the SSLC because I understood the strategy. The strategy was entrepreneurship. The thinking of mine was only entrepreneurship. That's why I was not focused on education. Then I realized when you need something, all the way, when you're going in a journey, you can't just leave away anything. And I didn't want to be a person without a degree. I don't want to tomorrow come and say, you know, look, I am a great entrepreneur, but I didn't study well. No, I didn't study well, but I have a degree. It's all about knowledge. And then you go to PUC, a science. They don't give you science. Then you take science. Again, you go down. And then you take engineering, you go off. And then University of Glasgow calls you. Because nobody else gives me an option here. Okay. So you go to the ultimate. And you're done. And I told my family, you got your degrees, now let me start my organization. I work for this company called Quintiles, they didn't give me a job. I was jobless for 10 months. During that period, I started 3 startups. Without money, using internet only. Then, my mother said, there's a loan. you have to go and repay your loan. So I went and worked for this company. I worked like, you have to work in the shifts and everything. And whatever money you get, you won't believe, I couldn't buy a chocolate for a rupee, because whatever money comes into the account, it goes into the loan. It's like the bank knows when the you know, salary is fallen. Then I bravely finished I didn't have a big loan, so just 2 lakhs or something. I finished it off, and I don't know whether I'm okay. She said, you have savings. I understood my family's plan was to make sure I don't get into entrepreneurship. Correct? They're all afraid. We have a bad history of entrepreneurship globally, but India has lost failures. And my father was also a fair businessman. So she was really afraid that this will get into this kind of thing. And then, but that doesn't stop me, because from my 6 years old, I've been only thinking of this. I sold maps in the class when I was in 6th and 7th by hand drawing them on a white sheet, because I was good at drawing, and I used to sell it for 50 paise inside the class, because students would forget bring the maps to their history and geography class. I sell it in ICSE. So they have these classes, you have to bring maps every day. And FMEU, out of 30 students, at least 10 people forget. And you have to go out of the class. So first, when I sold it for 50 paise. My friends didn't give me the money. Okay, and then I realized, and I was a very soft person. I'm not like anybody could scold me or hit me. I was the soft and the depressed or pushed down kid in the block. Then I realized, now, how do I get the money from this block? Then the next day, when the man sends the persons out of the classroom, then I went and sold him for 150 paise. Okay, he had to pay because he has to come inside the class, he has to show a map. So this happened without the teacher knowing, because I also dealt with her. You have to do a deal, you have to take a risk. The risk here was going out of the class. I enjoyed going out of the class. I had a map. Okay, but still it was more better outside than being inside. So this is how I recovered the 150. The 50 which my students, my friends, my beloved friends who waited for me to give me money. Okay. Which I recovered the next day through this. Again, I was honestly the same 50 paise. My honesty was there with the pricing. I didn't increase it. Just that recovery pattern was different. Okay. So this is how I worked with strategies. That strategy again I implemented on my education worked very well. So I was just preparing myself to start. Okay. Now we don't have money. At least HSBC is giving money. I wish he would also give me some money, you know, I have a nice heart. So you go to competitions, you're getting good. I'm saying the support is wonderful for you all. So when I did my engineering project, it was about biofuel, algae biofuel, I've told you. We spent 10,000 rupees on it to build it. That was the reason I could go to University of Glasgow. In the sense, we took that risk to build it. They just gave us a lot, no money. We thought they'd give us the money. At least the recovery money. We didn't get it. But the whole point was, how do you use that investment? My investment here was a project. My friend was waiting for the money. My partner, I used this investment to go to abroad. He thought it's just a waste and he ended up being an HP. He still works for HP. My good partner, who we were supposed to become business partners, he didn't choose my path or he didn't take the risk. The whole idea is, you don't take this, you will not get anything. How dare I get anything? Today, HSBC is there, you're getting cash flows. You won't be there every day. That I guarantee you. Okay, so ultimately I'm telling you that don't expect for a reward. The reward should come running to you, it doesn't matter what. Then when I came to Glasgow, we had a session of 7 days for entrepreneurship committee, like a good, wonderful thing. This is professional, where you have to build business plans perfectly. All of us are science students, okay? There I won, my team won the competition. Again, let me remind you, they don't have a cash prize. Okay, so I was like, what is this? Wherever I go, nobody gives me cash prize. The University of Glasgow is supposed to give. Okay, they said, no, we don't encourage you by giving money. Their whole idea was make a professional. Okay. So the whole point I'm trying to tell you is this was an added advantage for me. So I understood getting that money was very difficult. Even if you are the best, you will not get the money. So that doesn't hamper your success. That doesn't mean you are not successful. Of course, I was a successful person there. I could be the first, and I was the first, my team was the first, but money doesn't.